Hi. Hi, girl. What are you doing tonight? Can you come over to dinner?
Well, Ricky isn't coming home for dinner, but I could come.
Good.
What's the occasion?
Fred's old vaudeville partner's in town.
Not the other half of Laugh Till It Hurts with Mertz and Kurtz.
Barney Kurtz.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
I didn't even know he was in this country. He's been entertaining royalty all over Europe.
I saw the postcard.
Oh, that's right. Listen, can I borrow your big silver tray?
Sure. Oh, I'm afraid it's going to need a little cleaning.
Oh, that's all right. Thanks. We have to put on a little dog, so Barney will think Fred Mertz has done all right, too.
What do you mean? Fred has nothing to be ashamed of.
Oh, I know, but he's so jealous of Barney because Barney stayed in show business and got to be a big star.
Yeah.
Fred got out all of his press notices this morning and put them all around the room in discreet places.
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, my God.
And if he soft shoes through the living room one more time singing Red, Red Robin, I'm going to let him have it right in the beak.
Oh, no.
Say, can I borrow your old-fashioned cruet set, too?
Sure.
And let's see, your damask tablecloth. And
the napkin.
And the napkin. And let me see that. And the napkins. And your silver carving set.
Why don't you just leave everything here and borrow the apartment? I'm surprised you haven't asked me to dress up and go over and serve for you.
Well, for heaven's sake, I didn't think you'd mind my asking you to...
Oh, honey, you know I don't.
Oh, I know you don't mind.
Of course not.
Let's see, now, what else can I borrow that looks better than what I've got?
How about Ricky?
That's a thought. Hey, you know, that's not a bad idea you had.
You can't have him.
No, no, I don't mean that. I mean you dressing up like a maid and coming over and helping me serve.
Oh, well, I'll see you later, dear. You run home now. You've got a lot to do. You've got a lot to take
care of. Oh, come on now, Lucy. Won't you do it for me?
No.
Why not? I never asked you to do anything like this before.
Oh, honey, I can't do that. What would Ricky say?
Ricky's not home. Oh, come on now. You just got to do it for me.
I don't got to do it.
Well, think of all the hundreds of things I've done for you.
Now, honey, I don't ever ask you that.
Wonderful folks.
That was a wonderful show. Wonderful show. Honey, what was the name of that mind reader?
Alexander the Great.
That's right.
Alexander the Great. What a mind reader. He could tell you anything about yourself.
Good. Barney, whatever happened to him? Oh, he's working for the income tax department.
Barney, would you care for more beef?
Please, yes, please.
Bessie?
Madame rang.
Yes, Madame did. Mr. Kurtz cares for more beef.
Yes, ma'am.
Barney, tell us all about Europe.
Well, when I was making all those command performances before the crowned heads of Europe, I thought of your book. Really?
Imagine playing before royalty.
Well, they're just like ordinary people.
They are. Do they laugh and applaud?
I never will forget the first command performance in the London Palladium.
The London Palladium?
Oh, boy.
Oh, gosh.
Yes. You know, I was, I was very hot that night. You know, I kept it topical.
Yeah.
I said, a funny thing happened to me tonight on my way to Buckingham Palace.
Buckingham Palace?
Buckingham Palace.
They bring the beef.
Yes, ma'am. I'll hustle it right up, ma'am.
Bring some more potatoes, Bessie.
Yes, sir.
And some green beans.
Yes, ma'am.
And some rolls.
Yes, sir.
And could I have a spot of gravy, please?
Yes, ma'am. Sir.